It's the final countdown. What's up, troop? This ain't Coop, but I'm gonna give you the scoop if you're ready to come with me about the Hydra line controversy. You'll see. Testing, testing, 1, 2. Testing, testing, 3, 4. You're welcome to the Hydra line, the supreme being of all Hydras. They call me MC Hydra, ready to ride ya. Put you down, and then I'm gonna find you. Hey, what's up, everybody? MC Titan, and this is part 3 of the Hydra line controversy, the finale. Now, if you've seen part 1 and part 2, you've already know the story. But the overall premise is that when I first got the Hydra line, uprights, attachments, you know, when it first came out, everything had a rough and tough powder coat that I was impressed with because it was something that I had never seen before or felt before. And in fact, it felt warmer than my other uprights because I had other uprights around the gym, like the X3 from Titan, that were smooth, very cold, like freeze my hand as soon as I touched it. But the Hydra felt warmer, and I was like, you know what? I really like this, and the texture, I wasn't slipping on it. You know, I like to hold my uprights, and it kept my hands there unlike any other upright I'd ever seen. So, in that fashion, it was a new line, a new feeling, everything felt new and different. So I was impressed. So I kept buying and buying and buying and buying. Next thing you know, it was probably around November 20th. I first noticed the smooth 43-inch cross right that came with my rough globe attachment. Hey, now that that Bells of Steel security guard isn't watching me, he's actually sleeping. Check it out.
Goldilocks.
I can now do my tests, and I could show you what's up. Come with me. Hey guys, one of the things I really liked about the old style powder coating from Bells of Steel, and that I got excited about, was that it felt warmer. As you can see, can you see that? Oh, it's 60 degrees on the floor. I got my heater over here too going. 86 when you point it inside, 94. But check it out. This powder coating is 66 degrees. And this is the new style that just came in the box. I've been having them sit out here for a while. Let's see what temperature they are. They are 62 and 66. So I was not imagining that these were actually warmer to grab than these new style powder coated ones. They're a lot colder. Let's go with the gun. As you can see, the floor is reading 58 degrees. Let's go with the new style powder coat. It's reading 61 degrees. 62. New style, I mean old style. It is reading the motherfucking same. What the fuck? All right, as you can see from my Hydra seat, it's got some dust and skin particles all over it. But it is easily wipeable if I really wanted to wipe my old style powder coat all day. You can get it done, son. Same with my lever arms. As you can see, very dusty from all the hands going on it. Oh, even the orange came off. Ah, who wants that?
Powder coat. Powder coat. Powder coat. Goldilocks, Goldilocks, Goldilocks.
Okay, on December 28th, I sent another email about the smooth powder coat difference. No response. I waited 13 more days and forwarded the same email on January 5th. After Kayvon had commented on my part 2 video on December 29th about, all right, I have contacted my lead product developer. No one has requested any changes, nor has any machinery changed or paint supplier. Inconsistent powder coat application was his response. Let me know, I can make it right. You know, not everything he said, but that's basically the gist. So he says he can make it right, yet I'm not getting any emails back on the response on his team. So I waited a whole 13 days after I made that email, and they finally responded on January 6th. And they said, the current powder coat is not the same as the first generation batch. This was the first time they had said something about the powder coat, even though I kept addressing it. They did not want to keep the abrasive texture and wanted a more consistent coating without being abrasive, was their response. They offered nothing for my trouble. They just kind of basically said, that's what it is. Let us know if you would like anything else. And I was sitting there fuming. After Kayvon had already said, let me know what I can do. And then I get a response basically like, you're shit out of luck, son. So I chilled for a minute because I didn't want to sound angry with my response. So I responded, you know, yada, yada, yada. I like things to be consistent. You guys never said anything. I've addressed this and you still didn't know what the problem was. Yada, yada, yada. Can I get some kind of credit? That's what I asked for, because I felt like I deserved that, because things changed and they didn't let you know anything. And I actually liked that original powder coat. I mean, I thought it was the bomb, but I could see why they upgraded. Well, I wouldn't say upgraded, why they made it smoother and less abrasive, because yeah, you've got to clean your rack a lot. When you get your skin on there, dust, you got to keep wiping it, right? But with the smoother one, you know, it's like, it stays clean. But anyway, it's all about a matter of opinion on that one. So, I'm not going to disclose exactly what they gave me, but they responded back with a more PC. He must have went and talked to his boss and, oh yeah, that's that MC Titan guy. And then they're like, okay, yes, I understand your frustration, yada, yada, yada. Here is a credit. Will you accept this? So I'm not going to disclose exactly how much I got. You know, I really wanted that air salt assault runner with the farmer's carry thing. Man, send me one of those. You know what I mean? Shit, that looks sick. But anyway, that's the end of the story. And so basically, they're not saying anything different on their website. They didn't have any disclosures. It's just kind of being like, it is what it is, and they've moved on. I don't know if they've contacted other people with the abrasive powder coat who got a new updated version of the smooth powder coat and have inconsistencies in their Hydra line as well. I don't know what they've done on their end. Maybe some of y'all have experienced the same thing and can say if they've actually reached out to you and said anything, or they just kind of kept it hush because I don't have a million subscribers. Peace.